Terry Engel from Valley View Farms. We're inside because the weather is beginning to push us a little more inside, a little less outside here. We've still got a few projects to do outside to clean the garden up, but we're going to concentrate on the house this time.
We are, or a little of each. If you haven't brought in your house plants yet, please bring them in. They really should be brought in when the temperatures outside and inside are about the same. I brought my lime tree in a couple of weeks ago. But before you do that, you may want to spray it just to make sure you don't aren't bringing any insects inside.
And just, they'll love it.
They will
stink
love
bugs,
it.
Well, they're in the house anyway.
But we're not going to talk about stink bugs. No. There's stuff for that, too. But anyway, give all your plants just a little bit of spritz. We usually recommend an oil spray.
What's the most common thing that's brought in from outside when you bring in your chef or some aphids?
Yeah, probably aphids come in. On some of your plants, things like mealybugs or scale may come in. On my lime tree, that's what I'm primarily concerned about is scale. And for scale, you definitely need something that has an insecticidal oil in it. Because it actually suffocates the plant. What I do like to do is sort of do a double dose and hit all my plants with an insecticidal soap first, and that sort of softens the shell of scale and mealybugs and some of those hard-to-get-rid-of insects.
Because that shell on that little creature will repel stuff.
It will, and it just, and it really just takes over. It makes your plants sticky, and that's the symptom. A lot of people come in and go, I don't know, all of a sudden my leaves are all sticky
and
there's
dust
stuff
sticks
on
to the
floor.
Plant, and the plant just begins to look kind of shabby.
And that's how you know you have some insects. So take care of those before you bring them inside, but then also keep an eye on them. Because you may have to bring them back outside if we get a little warm weather spell maybe in January.
Is it good to really hose them down outside before you bring them in?
I think that's a great idea.
A good rinse down.
Yeah, and do it with, make if you can get the water where it's been heated a little bit with the hose, that's ideal.
Just where it's been sitting out in the sun for a while.
Exactly. Yeah.
And we still have, you know, I mean, we're running into November here, but we still have a few nice potential days here where some of that stuff can still be done.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. The other thing is now that we're getting into the first part of November, now's the last time to really feed your plants because now they want to go into a dormant state. So feed them one more time. Whatever your favorite food is, whether it's Miracle-Gro, we like the Monty's, Peter's, or even Osmocote, but get something on them to get them through the rest of the season.
Get that done before December, let's say. Is that kind of a good
rule? Yeah, because they're really going to slow down. They're not going to need as much water. They're not going to need as much food. What they're going to want that they have probably missed once they've moved inside is humidity. Mm-hmm. And to get that's what we have this little saucer here for.
And the sunshine is going away, too. The days are shorter, and they're in the house. So, I mean, there's double whammy there.
Exactly. In my own house, I've set up some plant lights, and that helps me get through this time and definitely helps the plants. And we're just putting this in. We're not going to put enough water in here to really bring the water up till we can see it, but we just want some humidity in there.
Generally, you want it where the stones are still exposed. You don't want the stones submerged in water.
Exactly right. And then we'll just take our plants, set them right in here.
So that's a humidifier.
It's a humidifier. It's an easy way to do it. It's inexpensive.
You can use more decorative pots than a little...
Sure.
Plant containers that we got there. But.
Absolutely. It's just fun. For bigger plants, do kind of the same thing. Again, big lime tree that I have is in a pot about this big. The saucer's a little bit bigger.
A few more stones.
That's it.
Okay. Good tip. Let's see. We have a little less than a minute. What should we be doing outside now that October is just kaput?
Well, I'd say now's probably a good time if we've had a couple of frosts and we're starting to get some really cool nighttime temperatures. Get your bulbs planted, your daffodils, your tulips, and your crocus. Get those planted. You may want to put a deer repellent on top of the area for things like your tulips. Daffodils aren't going to care. They're going to not be bothered by deer.
Do you mind to dig them up?
Deer and rabbits, squirrels, chipmunks, all those little guys. So just put down some kind of a repelzol to just keep them at bay so you won't be disappointed come spring.
Terry, thanks for joining us
this
morning. Next Sunday, we'll be back with more on Your Sunday Gardener. We'll see you then.
If you have a garden question, you can send it to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. You can also go on our website, WBALTV.com.